Hello, Klaus here, and welcome back to yet another video here at the channel. In today's video, we're going to have a look at how to create motion graphic or motion graphic statements inside of DaVinci Resolve without going into Fusion. You can do this right in the edit page. So without further ado, let's just jump right into DaVinci Resolve and let's get started. Let's go.
Okay, so here we are in DaVinci Resolve, and let's have a look at how to do this motion graphic pretty fast and pretty easy. So first off, let's go up to the effects, and I'll go into the titles, and it is super important to use a regular title to do this little thing. So I'm going to put down a regular title here, and then I'm just going to go up to the inspector, and I'm going to erase the text because we do not need that. So we are going to use emojis for this little motion graphic. And on Mac, you can push Control, Command, Spacebar at the same time and it will appear. And on PC, that will be Windows Tab and full stop. However, if you have a crappy keyboard like I do, these fancy shortcuts doesn't really work, but you can easily get to them anyways. You can just go up here and go in here and then go to Show Emotions and Symbols. And we are going to make sure that our text here box is selected, and we can then do our graphics. And we are going to do, let's just say, idea plus camera. And then we can go up here and we can just push the spacebar. And then we are just going to copy paste this text, selecting that, and we're going to write in the last of our sentence, which is going to be equals popcorn. Really a great statement, I think. And we're just going to make a little space in between. So this is basically how you would get the emoji into DaVinci Resolve. However, emojis is one thing, but to make motion graphic is to give it a little bit something else. So to work with these emojis, we simply need to right click and make a new compound clip. And I'm just going to do that. And I'm going to do the same for the second one as well. So now we have our little graphic here. And we can, for instance, scale that up if we want to and stuff like that. We are maybe going to scale it up just a little bit. However, I am going to add in a generator. I'm going to take a solid color and I'm going to put that underneath because I want to have a different color than black here. So I'm going to change the color into this yellowish one. So now we can see our little emoji statement here. And I want to add in an effect as well. And I like to use this paper edge effect here. I'm going to put that on the clip and I'll go up to the effects with that clip selected. And I'm just going to make the border a little bit bigger and then going down to the edge contrast. And I'm going to put that a little down. And I will actually go into the sizing here and I'll make it a little bit bigger, something like that. Back to the effects. And I'm going to fiddle around here with the effects. So if we want to move around the edge, we can go down to the edge position here and we can change that around so it'll look the way we want it, maybe like that. Maybe we're going to make the border a little bit bigger, something like that. Let's say that's what we want. And then want to right click here and just push copy because I want to do the exact same thing to my popcorn here. And I'm just going to right click again and I'm going to paste attributes. And in here, I'm just going to tickle this box here and I'm just going to apply. So now it has done more or less the same to my popcorn. However, I want these to be aligned a little bit differently. So I'm going to take the bottom one and I'll go up to the video and I'm just going to change the position so it'll be around here and then I'll take the top and again into the position and I'm going to position this something like that. If I then want to change something around with the popcorn because I didn't like it, I'll just change it in the effects again. Again here it's something with the edge position I want to change a little bit, something like that looks better. Also, a cool thing about the paper edge is that it actually does a drop shadow and we can change that of course if we want to. Something like that, if we really want to. But for now, I'll just keep it at the default. So I just also want to do a kind of an animation because just like this, it doesn't really look that good. I want this to come in. And a super easy way to do that actually would just be to go up to our video transitions. And I'm going to go all the way down to the fusion transitions. And I'm just going to use this fall and bounce. And I'm just going to put that on. So we're getting this effect here, and I'm going to put that effect or transition on the second clip as well. And then now we have this bounce, bing, and maybe I want the transitions to be a little faster. A cool thing to add in here is actually if you highlight the transition, you can go into the inspector, and in the inspector, we can actually just add in motion blur. And you can actually see what that does here. I think that it sells this effect way better, so I'm going to add that as well on the popcorn. So now we have this little motion graphic that ideas plus camera equals popcorn or entertainment, which is kind of true. Another thing we could do is just to add a little bit of movements. And also I want to actually go in here, and I'm just going to move everything just a little bit. Something like that looks pretty good to me. Again, we can add in a little more movement and stuff like that. And there's a ton of ways to do that. Again, the fastest way is to go up to the effects and just go up and take an adjustment clip and put that on top of everything. And in the transform, I'm just going to click right here to set in a keyframe. And then I'll just go to the end of my little animation here. And I'm just going to zoom in just a little bit. So now we have this wing and a little bit of movement. Pretty cool. And then of course we could add in even more if we really want to. And I like to add in things. So we could add in some elements like old VHS. And I have a bunch of those at the store, and you can pick some of those up. There are a paid version and there's the free version. Whatever you like. And we're just going to take this little piece here of a VHS overlay. And then I'm just going to go into the inspector with the VHS overlay selected. And in the composite mode, I'm just going to change this into screen like that. So now we're having these old VHS stripes. One last thing to add in. And this is a little thing. I'll go back to the effects. I'm going to take another adjustment clip, putting that on top of everything, changing the color so it's easier to see in the color page. I'm just going to make it orange, and you don't have to do this, but I'm just thinking that this looks a little too sharp. So I'm just going to go into the color page, and with that adjustment clip selected, I'll go over here in the blur, and I'm just going to blur this out just a little bit. Make it a little more soft. And then you just add in a little bit of sound design, and you have done a quick little motion graphic statement of your own. Anyway, I do hope you found this little video useful. If you did, please hit that subscriber button, give the video a like, share it with your friends if you think it would help them out, and if you want to be notified every time there's a new video on this channel, please hit that bell icon down in the corner. Until next time, keep filming, keep learning, and keep sharing.